So here we will see the next point, that is the types of changes. In types of changes, we discuss about the reversible change and irreversible change. So here we will see the next change, that is the fast changes. Now fast changes means what? See, fast changes, what is the proper definition of fast changes? See, the changes takes place in short time are called fast change. Means any change. Any change takes place in a short time. For example, see here, this is a job. Okay, now see size of job. If you will break it, means it takes within a second you can break this job. So this is a fast change. This is known as a fast change. For example, switching on fan. See, on and off light, okay, bulb and fan. These all are the fast change because it takes very less time. Then, breaking of ice. Breaking of ice in this way. You see, you can, breaking of ice is also example of fast change. So, fast change means it's require very less time. That all changes, means those changes are often very fast, and all changes are so fast. Now, the second one is a slow change. It is totally opposite of fast changes. Now, slow changes means what? Changes that takes longer time to complete are called slow changes. Means it takes more time to complete. For example, growing plants. You know that. But for growing plants, how much time it is needed? It is not very easy to complete. See, now the job you can break very easily within a second. But the growing plants, it need a more time to complete. Okay? So these changes are known as a slow change. Then curding of milk. Curding of milk is another example of slow change. Then rusting of iron. It also takes a long time. So those are taking a long time to complete, and all the changes are as a slow change. Now the third one is periodic change. This is totally new for me. Okay? The periodic change is what? Change that are repeated at regular interval are called as a periodic change. Now here the two words are very important. See, regular intervals. Okay, change that are repeated means that change is repeating again and again. But at regular interval are called as a periodic changes. Means some changes are like that are repeating again and again, but particular time that all the changes are known as a periodic change. So it is known as periodic change. For example, changes of day and night. See, day and night, we know that now after means evening, then night start, then again morning is day and night, it is regularly it is there. So this is the example of periodic change. Then next change is there, that is the non-periodic change. Non-periodic change is totally opposite of periodic change. Now here the regular interval is important, and it is repeating at means after a some time. So it is a periodic, and non-periodic means changes that are not repeated at regular interval are called as non-periodic change. Here the word is important, that is a not. Means it is not a repeated change, okay? We don't know when this change will occur. We are not knowing anything about that. That changes are known as a non-periodic change. Then we see the example before 2-3 days is the Nisarga cyclone. You know about that, and because of that the major destructions occurs, okay? This is a non-periodic change. Means we were not knowing this change will occur in this month, okay? And it is not a repeated again and again. So these type of changes are known as a non-periodic change. Earthquake also we are not knowing when it will happen, and it is not a repeated. So these non-periodic changes is totally opposite of periodic change. So today we learn these four types of changes, that is first one fast change. Fast change means it requires less time. Slow change means it requires more time to complete. Then topics. We will learn in next lecture. Thank you.